Did you feel like a liability growing up?
No, I felt, well, for me, like, I felt what they feel is there's nothing wrong in what they feel, but I didn't feel that I am any less than my brother or, you know, and I'm just a, you know, someone who they have to take care of. I felt quite independent, but that's very rare.
But your parents also want you to get married off at 16?
Not really. I had pressure of, you know, studying and things like that, but my parents, you know, I come from a joint family and they had, you know, their own pressures on them. But yeah, they definitely didn't think of me doing something other than getting married and taking care of my household.
What made you finally take the decision to almost run away from home, come here to the city where you had no sugar daddy, you knew nobody?
Yeah.
People made fun
of myself as someone who's any less than my brother or anyone else. And that's something that drives you to just find yourself and your worth. I didn't have any clarity that I want to be an actress or I want to change the world or do this, but that frustration that I can't be what you think I am, you know. I can't be such a useless person who's just good for nothing and just, you know, do post-graduation, then they'll find a guy for me and then I go about, you know, making babies. So I did have a lot of doubts about that system, but I had, you know, so many doubts about my own choices in life.
How difficult was it for you when you came here?
Very difficult. I mean, it's quite harsh, and I don't have to go into the details of it, but...
But you went days without food, you slept on the pavement?
Yeah, and then I fell for a trap. Like, you know, I was physically abused, and I, you know,
by whom?
You know, like, I don't want to take names, and...
By people in the industry?
Yeah, yes, people, you know, when they see needy people, and it's just not that, you do fall for those traps, and you do feel that, you know, people sometimes might help you without, you know, but there are no free lunches, right? So when you're naive, you're young, you kind of, you do, you know, fall for those very conventional, you know, discover yourself. But I feel there are as many people, as many stories, as many women, and we need to encourage women, our women, for being who they are, as opposed to trying to box them and fit them. This one is attractive, this one is, you know, Benji type, this one is intellectual, and this one is a baddie, you know, badass who has boyfriends. And we're close like this. So we need to stop boxing our women.
Yeah, go beyond the stereotypes and the cliches. You were one of the first people, at least I think you were the first person I ever heard in the industry who asked why women are not paid as much as men. And I've heard the counter argument that women don't bring as many audiences, they don't, you know, do as well for the distributors. How sexist, how discriminatory do say we need to be paid more? Did you answer that
question? Oh yeah, I think we are made to feel extremely, you know, because, I don't know, this is the mentality where in India we have that overtly ambitious women is just kind of looked down upon. Which is also very, very, you know, I don't think that's the case though. They will make you feel that way, that if you're being overly ambitious, you are definitely not, you know, no one's going to admire you and you're not a nice person. But then, in my experience, more successful I get, you know, I see a lot more proposals from men. Why is that then? Isn't it? Like, you know, I've been around for like some 10 years and more successful I get, more crazy they get. Why is that? And these are the same guys, you know, who will tell me that, you know, the date shani kisi ko achhi nahi lagti. You know, and these are the same guys now, you know, head over heels. So why is that? I want to know that.
Yeah, there's no Meryl Streep in here.
Yeah.
Is that frustrating? Do you work in this industry knowing that the men are going to be forever young while the women are put on the shelf? And, well, most women seem to be, have 5-6 years, mm-hmm. if they're lucky.
Mm-hmm.
How does that make you feel?
Again, I think it's just the way, it's a kind of manipulation. They manipulate us to feel that way, to believe that way. But it's not true. If that was true, I mean, who would remember the last glamorous, hot, bald face? Everyone remembers that though, you know, like the woman that I played with Buffy.
Yeah.
Everyone remembers Queen. Our society loves raw character. We love raw women. We don't love our mother because she's hot and sexy. We love our mother because she's our mother. You know, and we love our granny because she's our granny. We value her. We don't remember anyone's face from our childhood. We love our granny's face, you know. So our society loves. If that wasn't the case, why would Dutta be such an iconic character?
Yeah.
You know, my Krish character is not iconic. The one where I feel really hot as
mentally. But yet the men last longer than the women. In the role of hero.
Because they make us believe that. They don't want us to be, they want us to be a certain way. They make us lose our identity. It's a trap. It's a trap. We need to be aware of this trap. They will make you lose your identity, and then you won't like yourself, they won't like you either. So when a man says that, oh, you're not 16, or you're not 15, you have your first wrinkle. You know, don't hate yourself for that. Love yourself, he'll follow you. So we need to love ourselves first. You know, we are desperate to look all the time a certain way. But in my experience, I can only speak for myself. All my hot characters or whatever, I mean, by the grace of God, I never got any attention. But the day I played real women, you know, and that we can't give credit to the industry. We have to give that credit to our audiences, our population. They love real characters, they love raw women. And I don't care, why would anyone care if Queen is actually 27 or 37? How do you make the difference?
Yeah.
What difference does it make? If it doesn't make a difference to film industry, they wouldn't want you to feel that way. You get extremely threatened, you know? So, I mean, we don't have to fall for that. Try to be aware of your gifts.
One of the things I really applaud you for is that you had a 2 crore rupee offer to do a fairness cream ad. And you not just turned it down, you said you're embarrassed and ashamed of every colleague of yours in the industry. And this includes both men and women and some of the biggest stars who do market fairness products. What made you say that?
Like I said, I really thank my ex, white guy who I was dating, because growing up, I didn't come through conversations like this, and I thank you and people like you who, I don't know how much change people like you can bring about, but at least you're talking about it. The one who is willing to have that awareness, or maybe fortunate enough to have that awareness, would actually get it from you. So growing up, I didn't see anything wrong with fairness cream. In fact, I thought it was actually cool to be fair or not to be fair.
So did you use it?
I think I was quite pale growing up. I didn't need it, but I didn't see anything wrong with fairness cream. But when I was dating this white guy, he teased me like, "Oh, you guys are so funny. You openly sell fairness cream. It's not acceptable, And I'm like, why is that? It's like, because it's not acceptable that, you know, you're trying to tell your race that you shouldn't be this way and that's the time actually I realized that what we are doing, how we are sort of giving our generation complexes and not letting them be confident and not letting them find beauty in their own race, you know. And it's just this whole new world opened up to me, and I'm like, what are we doing as people? The whole world is laughing at us, you know. And he used to tease me that, so you must be thinking that I am fair and lovely because I'm white. And I hated that. And I think in a relationship also, you wouldn't want to have, the other person have that kind of upper hand because you as population behaving so stupid, you know. So,
what do you think of your colleagues who do market fair and lovely or fairness products?
Fairness product. I think it's very, very irresponsible. If tomorrow I have a dark kid, who's got, who's, like I said, dark, I don't want my kid to think that he needs to get lighter or she needs to get lighter. I would be extremely embarrassed and wouldn't know how to deal with the situation if my child is watching that at work. I wouldn't know how to tell him or her that it's supposed to be that way. I wouldn't know, because the whole world is saying something else, and I would be in a very, very awkward situation.
So you're embarrassed by your colleagues in the industry who market these products?
You need a headline, don't you?
And you're giving me one. Speak openly. Do you feel angry when you see others do it? Do you feel contempt? Do you just ignore it?
Well, I definitely feel embarrassed. We don't have to be fair. There's so many things we can work on, but definitely not our complexion. We are perfect. And, like I said, there beauty is everywhere, but we need to make our women confident. We need to let them find their confidence. And when you show an advert where a brown person goes to for an interview and gets humiliated, and then she goes back and puts on this thing and goes back being a little bit more lighter and get the job. I mean, what are you saying? Like, I mean, come on, like, this is so stupid.